हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सतीश परयानी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, शोलापुर। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ व्हाट आर द स्किल्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन, स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड प्रैक्टिस स्किल्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। First, we'll understand what are the basic skills, and the different skills required are communication, influence, leadership, motivation, negotiation, and problem solving. Let us understand first the basics. As a project manager, you have to rely on project management knowledge, which you have gained from the past experience, and your general management skills, which you have practiced in your previous or which you have seen while working with project managers. So in short, these two skills, project management skills, your knowledge has to be taken from your previous projects or your previous bosses with or your previous colleagues with whom you have worked out. Ability to plan the project, execute it properly and control it, and bringing it all successful conclusions. To guide the project team to achieve the project objectives and balance project constraints. So these two important features have to be there in the project manager and his team. They should able to plan the project properly, execute it, control it, and finally successful closure, or means a successful conclusion, a successful closure or handover in some project should be there. Let us say in example of SAP, when the SAP installation is there, a kind of project for new company is there, there a successful come after completion, a project handover should be there to the company, because a SAP implementation persons cannot stay long. They will support you hardly after implementation 6 months or 1 year, depending upon the contract what they have done with your company. Also, to guide the project team to achieve project objectives and plan project constraints, these are the skills we have to be required. So let us understand in depth each skill. In some respects, managing a project is similar to running a small business. A business, we can say. There are risks, there are rewards, financial and accounting activities, human resource issues, time management, stress management, and purpose of project to exist. Last but not the least, you have to bring the ability in the project to manage personal relationship and deal with personal issues as they arise. Here we are talking of your interpersonal skills, which you have to develop over a period of time. Let us understand the first important is communication. Project management spends 90% of their time in communicating. Either they are communicating via verbal on phone, either they are communicating via mail. Therefore, they must have a good communicators. Not only he should have that skill, but his team also should have. He should continuously motivate them, promote clear, unambiguous exchange of information. As a project manager, it is your job to keep a number of people well informed. It is essential that your project staff knows what is expected of them, what they have to do, when they have to do it, and what budget and time constraint and quality specification they are working towards. Within time budget, within money budget, they have to work it out. So you have to communicate very clearly, ye kaam mujhe itna hi hona hai. We have to do it according to. If the project staff members do not know what their tasks are or how to accomplish them, then the entire project will grind to the halt. Finally, if you are uncertain of what the customer expects of you, then the project will not even get off the ground. Project communication can thus be summed up as knowing who needs what information and when, and making sure they have it. Now, the second important skill, what we are talking of, influence. Project management is about getting things done. Every organization is different in its policies, modes of operation, and underlying culture. They are political alliance, different motivations, conflicting interest, and power struggles. A project manager must understand all the unspoken influences at work within an organization. Who get motivated by what? Someone get motivated by praises. Someone do not like the praises in front of every organization. Someone is more supportive or more influenced by some coupons the company provides. Sometimes the negative motivation is also there. Positive motivation, negative motivation, both works. So we have to understand the influence. What project manager must understand his team members, how they are getting influence. Now, third important quality, what we are speaking, is the leadership. Leadership is very, very important quality. Is the ability to motivate and inspire individuals to work towards expected goals or expected results. Leaders inspire vision and rally people around the common goals. A good project manager can motivate and inspire the project team to see the vision and value of the project. He will lead, and his colleagues will do what he says, and they have to believe on that leader. He have to create that impact. The project manager as a leader can inspire the project team to find solutions to overcome perceived obstacles to get work done. Now, the next important, again, we are talking, the skill is motivation. Now, these what skills we have already spoken are interrelated with each other. So now comes the motivation. Motivation helps people work more efficiently and produce better results. Motivation is a constant process that a project manager must guide to help the team move towards completion with the passion and profound reasons to complete their work. Motivation, as I told in the few minutes back, motivation can be a positive motivation. Motivation can be a negative motivation. A negative motivation means you are scolding, and somebody do not like scolding, and so he can do the work. So once you scold him, he will try to finish his work early. Somebody don't like punishments. You can cut some basic perks, 1 day, 2 days, something like that. So this is negative motivation. But managers should ensure that negative motivation should not be tool to resolve. Generally, positive motivations, continuously counseling should be done with his team. Motivating the team is accomplished by using a variety of team building techniques and exercises. Team building is simply getting a diverse group of people to work together in the most efficient and effective manner possible. Different motivation techniques are available, different exercises are there. Recognition and rewards are the important part of the team motivation. They are formal ways of recognizing and promoting desirable behavior and are more effective when carried out by the management team and project manager. Consider individual preferences and cultural differences when using rewards and recognition. Some people don't like to be recognized in front of group, others thrive on it. Next important is negotiation. Project managers must negotiate for the good of the project. They have to negotiate with the top management, they have to negotiate with the bottom, they have to negotiate with outside world. In any project, the project manager, the project sponsor, the project team will have to negotiate with the stakeholders, vendors, customers to reach the level of agreement acceptable to all parties involved in the negotiation process. The next important is problem solving. Problem solving is ability to understand the heart of the problem. Look for the viable solution and then make a decision to implement that solution. The starting point for the problem solving is problem definition. Problem definition is the ability to understand the cause and effect of the problem. Cause and effect has to be there. Without cause and effect, if we are dealing only with the solutions, it can root cause analysis should be done. Many times, if symptoms are being, suppose if the symptoms are being treated, then this can lead to a big problems. Root cause analysis looks beyond immediate symptoms to the cause of the symptoms, which then efforts. Ishikawa diagram is best example. Ishikawa diagram has to be used. Once the root of the problem has been identified, decision must be made to effectively address the problem. Root cause analysis looks beyond the immediate symptoms to look cause of the symptoms, which then affords opportunity for the solution. Once the root problem has been identified, decisions must be made to effectively address the problem. Now think, the main skill initially required by the member of the project manager is in overseas project, what I am talking, where the both parties are from different countries, is communication. True or false? Yes, the answer is true, because this is important for project manager and his team, because initially they need to understand each other to make up rapport so that they can communicate on the common ground. Then the further skills, motivation, negotiations can be applied. First, they need to communicate very clearly. Now the references used are from NPTEL and some project management group and controlled by Narendra Singh, Himalaya Publications. Thank you.